Honey, aren't you doing a mission during Christmas? That's relentless, bud. I hate to hear that for you. But you know I don't ever mind being in business, so. Welcome back. I think you're already familiar with it. Just a couple different editions, but what country are they shipping you to this time? Oh wow, that's gonna be a treat. How long are you gonna be gone for? Not too long. You'll be back by Christmas? Okay, that's good to know.
I'm keeping an eye on the clock because I got places to be.
Up here in the mountains, it's supposed to get down to like -8. And I really don't want to get stuck up on this hill for Christmas. My family's expecting me down in the city, back in the city. So I've got your... Well, me and my team pulled the file, yeah, but this has everything you need to know about the subject.
And the target.
So. I trust you know how this thing works, right? You should plug it into your computer and common stuff. Alright, there you go. And then. You had too many stamps in the last one. Obviously, you have government authorization for your travels and stuff like that, but you know, flying under the radar is important when you're doing these kinds of missions, so we don't really want the
boss to know what's going on either.
But yeah, we got a new printer and this one actually looks really good, so.
Like I always tell you, I'm an advocate for the 20-rounders because they're, you know, less clunky, less stuff to get hung up on.
Easier to stick into any sort of profile than for a magazine well or anything like that, so. What's this one? PMAG. But a couple of these will have the
also compatible with your night vision goggles, so in the event that you're going rogue, you just click this button right here.
It says NV for night vision. Don't you just love that sound?
Nice audible click. Beautiful. Check it out.
So that's sort of what the reticle looks like. And you can turn up the brightness or turn it down.
And if you ever need to turn it off, you can. You just press down the up and down arrows at the same time. Watch. Easy stuff. If you run out of batteries, the battery compartment. Although I was peeping that Omega watch you're wearing, you won't want to take that too deep, even though it is a dive watch.
I guess they're trying to turn you into James Bond.
Respect. One of my favorite characters, too. For sure.
But the battery's a CR123. Common stuff.
For you operators, see, I think they should just use double A's or triple A's. Well, for instance, if you're behind enemy lines and you're like, hey, my laser or my optic is no longer working. Anybody got a CR123 sitting around? Most people are gonna say no. But if you ask for a AA or AAA battery, you know, here you go. Here's my remote for my television. Plug it right in.
You see what I'm saying?
Whatever. Industry standards. I think it's all marketing schemes for these people to make more money. Who knows?
All I know is that it should be a AA.
Pardon me. Cold weather's getting me a little sick. Again.
The RS regulate mount here. This just slides over your side rail. And it pops on like that. Just let that switch there.
If you need to tighten it, there's a little spring here. So that's how that works. Rule of thumb though, make sure this is turned off after you use it. No, it doesn't have a self timer, it should, but it doesn't. And the last thing you want to do is be walking around and all of a sudden you realize you forgot to turn off your battery and then you're using your iron sights, which we'll get to in a second. They're quite effective, but not as good. So, let me just show you the rifle a little further. I'll pop the dust cover off and you can take a quick look under the hood if you will, you know. Okay.
I know you're going to that one country, so obviously it's important that the language is spot on,
so. This is a pursed for laser.
If you need to adjust the windage elevation, that's going to be right here.
Mm-hmm. But you'll need like a penny or a flathead or something like that. I'm not sure what their currency is called over there, but something like that should also work. That's for visible laser there. Switch it over there for the infrared. So, again, if you're using the night vision like I think you're going to be doing, because you're cool like that, you're going to want to hit the NV on the EOTech as well as the IR on the laser. So when you're using the laser, you're the only one that could see it with the knots. Yeah, that's how that works.
It's actually pretty cool stuff. Unless you're on the receiving end, then it's not very cool at all.
It's the opposite. Cool. Yeah. Moving on.
The pressure switch. You got a pressure switch right here. Which turns on the green laser.
You also got one back in the back here. ASMR? Oh, yeah, it's this thing that I've been watching lately to help me sleep. You know, I have terrible memories from my past services, so sometimes I gotta tune into the ASMR.
Calms you down a little bit.
Okay, so
this particular is a 14.5
inch barrel, a little shorter than the common 16. It's also got a pinned muzzle brake here to keep that barrel hot from flipping up during sustained fire, so you can really let this thing rip. Now, I'm warning you, your teammates, if they're on either side of this thing, are going to get quite a bit of concussion, so keep that in mind before you just let it rip right down the hallway there on both sides. Because it has a rough, you know, kind of the same effect as a flashbang at that point. Don't ask me how I know that.
Moving on to the flip-up sides here.
This is one of the better things about AK, because it's just built in to the platform.
Some of the problems with these newer builds, ARs and all that stuff, is that you're attaching sides. Front post, rear sides, all that good stuff. And those screws come loose. Was this is just pinned. All this stuff is just, it's really bomb proof. It's not going anywhere, so that's good. But there's your front post side. I've already gone to the Liberty to dial this thing in for you, so you're not going to need to do any siding.
Rear post here. Now, this is kind of weird. I would just leave it alone, but I'm going to explain it to you.
This is going to adjust for elevation, bullet drop, all that stuff.
So, if you're taking shots out to like 900 meters or so,
you would flip that up to 900, there you go, or 1,000. And you see how it's lifting this post at the same time when you do that. Watch this.
Yeah, it's pretty good stuff, so.
Like I said, I'll leave it at the very bottom. You don't really need to adjust that while you're doing the EOTech stuff, so
just leave it out of this for now. But in case you do break the EOTech or forget to turn the battery off, which I bet you will, there's how to do that. Let's see. Oh, okay.
There's your side rail. That's how you mount your optical. I'll show you that in a second.
Let's go into the hood, though. This is my favorite part. Now,
I recommend
does get popped off. It's okay. It's called a dust cover, and you're not going to anywhere dusty, but you are going somewhere really cold and snowy. So leave it on still. But I've made some adjustments. We have a finely tuned recoil spring here. This is, it's made for more gas in your system, meaning you can attach a suppressor to this, no problem. Just make a fine-tune adjustment on this, and you'll be feeding just fine.
I took a look at your document, and it looked like you're going loud, so we're probably not going to have to worry too much about that, but
if you do want to run a suppressor, you know I got you covered.
Yeah. Now to our bolt. Dirty. Probably could have cleaned it for you, but it's okay. You don't have to do that now. You just make some adjustments here to aid with that suppressor if you end up putting it on.
But like I said, I've got it already tuned for how you're going to be setting it. So.
I would have something clever to say, but in reality, just drop that paperweight, because that's all it's going to be at that point. Just drop that paperweight and get out of town. But this one's brand new, so you should be in good shape. What's this? This is where the firing pin is housed. Cycles. Basically, attaches the round there. But if you need to take it out, you just twist it.
It comes right out like that.
And you do want to make sure that after a long day, you want to take this out and really scrub it down. You can even use your toothbrush if you need to, put some CLP, clip oil, or something like that.
So, now you know.
But this one's fine, because I just cleaned it for you, like I said, so.
And it's brand new. Let's put it back in here. Just like this.
Now we'll take a look.
I don't know if you're going to be able to see it or not, but just say you're more.
The barrel. It's brand new. We just put it in. Adjusted it finally for your mission.
It's got a nice one in, I think it's a 1-in-7 twist, so it's gonna feed these rounds very accurately.
For an AK. Moving down. We got a This is a little strange, so you're going to want to put your thumb here. Pull down like this.
So as you can see, it's gonna stay put. But if you need it, you just grab and pull. You'll hear a little click there. Here's our grip as well. We also have an ALG trigger, which is very nice. It's a drop-in trigger. Much smoother than the Tapcos and stuff that come with the Centuries and stuff like that. Those are terrible. This is actually a very nice trigger. Also, you can see here we have a polished hammer. I've gone in myself with a Dremel and really polished that down for you so that when you go to cycle the rifle, there's no hang up. That can be a big problem with guns, you know, but you know me. I always make sure that I give you the best. Nothing I wouldn't take out myself, okay? So this is gonna do the job just fine on that crazy mission you're going on. But yeah, nice and polished as you can see. What time is it? Okay, it's getting a little late. I'm gonna have to wrap this up pretty soon. So make sure that's put back in there nice and neat. Just like that. So let's go ahead and put her back together. See how easy that slid over that polished hammer? Yeah, it's a big difference. And we'll put our dust cover back on. Yeah, that's my plane. I'm gonna have to get going, but let's go ahead and put this back together. We're almost done. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this back on for you so that you can see how this works. Just slides on from the back here, like this. And then you just clamp it down. And this is actually a very strong mounting system. You can do push-ups and stuff on it. Not that you want to, because you're already shredded. Like a Julian salad, bro. Okay. So, I'll just leave this with you. You understand, but if there's anything else you need, please let me know. If not, I got a jet. Okay, well, my friend, have a merry, very merry Christmas. You've done a great job this year, so after this mission, why don't you take a couple weeks for yourself, maybe go down to the Bahamas, have a couple daiquiris and stuff like that. Sure thing. Okay, deal. Well, as always, it's a pleasure doing business with you, and I hope you're safe, and I look forward to seeing you again next time. I hope they're not leaving me.